Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy, and we are discussing motion in one dimension. This is a lecture number 9. I hope you have already watched part 1 to part 3 before watching. In last lecture, we had discussed the relative with the graphical representation of relative velocity. So, let us see. And suppose there are two cases I can take here. Say, two bodies are moving, their positions are given different. But they moving with the same speed, then what will happen in that case? So here, if I can initial displacement of a particle is 0, and here x is equal to position is, position of two particle is 10 meter from origin, and position of B particle is 0, that is starting from rest, when time is 0, say time is 0. And both are moving, speed of A and speed of B is same, velocity of A and velocity of B is same, and that is say 60 km per hour or even 60 km per hour, say like this, or even because in a standard form let's try here 20 meter per second or 10 meter per second, say 10 meter per second. So position is here. In position time graph, this is a position time graph. In position time graph, the velocity will be the slope of the two lines, you know, slope of lines will be the velocity. This is origin, here time is this side and position x is this side, that is position, right? And here this time. So in this graph, the velocity of A and velocity of B, the relative velocity of A with respect to B can be calculated as velocity of A with respect to ground minus velocity of B with respect to ground, that is BA minus BB. And since both has same speed, so 10 minus 10 is 0. So what A has appeared, B has in rest, and B will appear also A in terms of rest. Similarly, velocity of B with respect to A, velocity of B minus velocity of A, that is with respect to ground, this is understood fact, and 10 minus 10 is 0. So whether A appears, observe B is in rest, and B observe A is in rest. I hope you got this point, okay? Case 2, when two bodies moving with different speed, right, in same direction, right? Different speed but in same direction, then position time graph can be calculated as, you see, this one is of A starting from this point is like this, right? Say this is a starting from at position 10 meter above this, and moving with this speed, while B is starting from rest and moving in this is A and this is B. So this is A and this one is B. Speed of two bodies. This is position time graph. We can conclude here. This one is position time graph. That is time in second. And here position. Position in meters. In meter, right? And the unequal speed body has, this is the initial, that is 10 meter, this is origin, time is increasing and position is increasing. This, in this way, the position of A is 10 meter, position of B is 0 starting from rest. This is called point of reference. A point of reference is very important, from where we are observing the position of a body. or speed or acceleration, whatever, everything will be relative. Even displacement will be also relative. So relative displacement of A with respect to B, if I am saying here the relative displacement, if I am writing relative displacement of A with respect to B, can be also written as XAB, that is displacement of A minus displacement of B, that is 10 minus 0 is 10 meter. So the distance between A and B is 10 meter initially. Similarly, acceleration can be also calculated, a relative acceleration of one body with respect to another body. So don't worry about the word relative. This is not only applicable for velocity, but it is also similarly applicable for acceleration as well as for displacement as well. So here they have an equal, and at this point of time, body B cross body A. At this point of time, you know, body A, B cross body A. This time, at this point of time, body B will cross body A. So this is what the representation, right now. So if two particles are moving with the same speed, their relative velocity in same direction, say particle A is moving in this direction with a speed of 60 km per hour, just an example, and B is also moving in this direction with a speed of 60 km per hour, right? Both the particles are moving, and even though their distance between these two is 100 meter even, or 0 meter or whatever, but they appear and is looking relative velocity of A, particle is moving here, particle is B here, and moving in this direction, but the speed is same, so the distance between them is always remain 100 meter, whatever the time may be, because their speed is same. So relative speed of A with respect to B, in that case, relative velocity of A with respect to B is relative speed of A, velocity of A minus velocity of B, and both are 60, so 60 minus 60 is 0 kilometer. So they will appear, so A and B, therefore A and B will appear in rest with respect to one another, right? But if they are moving in opposite directions, suppose velocity of A is moving in this direction, and B is, distance between them is 100 meter, and B is moving in this direction, their speed is 60 km per hour. Say this one is also 60 km per hour. Then relative velocity of A with respect to B can be calculated as velocity of A minus velocity of B with respect to ground, right? So velocity of B, A is taken as positive, then B will be negative. So velocity of A is 60, then velocity of B will be minus 60. That is 120 km per hour, because BA is minus of BB. So that is why if BB is 60, then BA is minus 60. BB is minus of BA, or BA is minus of BB. You can write anything, right? So if VA is 60, then VB is minus 60, so 120 km per hour. It means both the bodies are getting separated with the speed of 120 km per hour. So this is what the meaning of relative velocity. I hope you got the point. Now let us discuss some numericals. Consider some numericals, and question is there. A jet airplane traveling at a speed of 500 km per hour ejects its product of combustion at a speed of 1500 kilometer per hour relative to the jet plane. What is the speed of ladder? What is the speed of ladder? Speed of ladder, that is combustion, right? With respect to an observer on the ground, right? So this is a question here. See, there is an observer, a jet is moving like, see, this is a, like a jet is moving, and here this is made, and here this is a combustion product of material is moving here. The jet is moving in this direction with the speed of 500 km per hour, right? This speed is a speed with respect to ground, and there, so let Vj represent velocity of jet with respect to ground, that is 500 km per hour. Also, it is given that velocity of combustion with respect to jet, velocity of combustion with respect to jet is given -1500 km. Why this is -1500? Because this direction and rate of combustion is in this direction, that is 1500 km per hour is given. So because they are opposite direction, so that is why you can write here -1500 km. Now, velocity of observer is on ground, velocity of observer with respect to ground is zero. To ground is zero because he is in rest. Now we have to calculate velocity of combustion. We have to calculate velocity of combustion with respect to observer. That we have to calculate. That is velocity of observer with respect to velocity of combustion with respect to observer. Sorry, velocity of combustion with respect to observer. Combustion with respect to observer. With respect to observer. That we have to calculate. So now velocity of combustion with respect to observer can be calculated as velocity of combustion with respect to ground minus velocity of observer with respect to ground. But we know this is first. Here velocity of combustion with respect to ground is not known, right? Velocity of combustion with respect to ground is not known, but that is velocity of combustion with respect to ground is not known, but velocity of combustion with respect to jet is given. Velocity of combustion with respect to jet is given, that is velocity of combustion with respect to ground minus velocity of jet with respect to ground is given. Velocity of combustion with respect to ground is given, that is -1500. minus 1500 and velocity of combustion with respect to ground that we don't know. So we can write here velocity of jet with respect to ground is 500 km. So therefore velocity of combustion with respect to ground, can we calculate it? Isn't it? Velocity of combustion with respect to ground. Combustion with respect to ground is minus 1500 plus 500. That is minus 1000 km per hour. Now putting the value here, we will have velocity of this is minus 1000 km and velocity of observer with respect to ground is 0. So velocity of combustion material as observed by observer is minus 1000 km per hour. That is, it is approaching to the observer. That is, observer think, observer observe that, combustion takes place with the speed of 1000 km per hour towards him, right? That is approaching to him. So 1000 km per hour, that will be the speed, right? Negative sign so is that it will be opposite to the direction of velocity of jet. Now next question. Let us see the next question is here. A police van is moving on highway at the speed of 30 km per hour, fires a bullet on thief's car, speeding away at the speed of 192 km per hour. If the speed of muzzle is 150 meter per second, if the speed of muzzle, that is muzzle speed of bullet is 150 meter per second, right hand, if the muzzle speed of bullet is 150 meter per second, then find the speed by which bullet will hit thief's car, right? Find this is what, at what speed bullet will hit the thief car. This is the question. So here there are, just before solving the question, you should know that what is the given and what is this. Police van is moving with the speed of 30 km per hour. So here the speed of van with respect to ground is given. The speed of police van, here velocity of police with respect to ground is 30 km per hour. That is 30 into 5 by 18 meter per second. 6, 3 is 18. And 6 by 30, so that is 25 by 3 meter per second. This is one thing which is given. Also it is given that velocity of thief with respect to ground is 192 km per hour. That is 192 into 5 by 18 meter per second. That can cancel by 6 can cancel. Yes. Or, 6 3 is 18 and 6 can cancel this, 6 3 is 18 and 6 2 is 12. So this is 160 upon 3 meter per second. Now speed of bullet with respect to police van is given, that is what, 150 meter per second. It is given. Now speed of bullet with respect to police van is given. So speed of bullet with, we have to calculate speed of bullet with respect to thief car, right? Now that we have to calculate. So speed of bullet minus speed of thief with respect to ground. So here we don't know what is the speed of bullet with respect to ground. So we can calculate from here only, right? Now these are all vector quantity, you can write it like this. So speed of bullet with respect to police age means what? Speed of bullet with respect to ground minus speed of police van with respect to ground. But speed of bullet with respect to police van is given 150, and speed of this one, right now, speed of bullet with respect to ground we do not know. Right now, speed of bullet with respect to ground we don't know, but the speed of police van with respect to ground, that is 25/3. So therefore speed of bullet with respect to ground is 150 plus 25/3. It means that will come 450 plus 25, that is 475/3 meter per second. Now from first, speed of bullet with respect to thief is given as speed of bullet with respect to ground, that is 475/3 minus speed of thief with respect to ground, that is 160/3. So that will come up here. If you are putting all this value, this will be 475 minus 160 whole divided by 3. That is 5, 7 minus 6 is 1, and 315/3, that can cancel, 105 meter per second. So speed by which bullet will hit the thief car is 105 meter per second. You can write the speed by which bullet will hit the thief car, will hit the thief's car, thief's car is 105 meter per second, right? Okay. Now the next question is, there is one more question, and the question is here. Let me write. Two towns A and B are connected by bus services at regular interval of T minute from either side. A man moving with the speed of 20 kilometer per hour on his bicycle observes that the bus crossing him after every 18 minutes in same direction and every 6 minutes from opposite direction. Find the speed of buses and time interval t. Right, this is the question. So we have to calculate this question, and how to deal with this questions, let me explain. Let v be the speed of each bus, right? And vc is the speed of cyclist. So speed of in same direction, the speed of bus with respect to cyclist is the speed of bus minus the speed of cyclist, right? This is VBC, speed of bus with the speed of cyclist. And time given that in same direction, time is 18 minute, that is 18 by 60 hour. Because this is in kilometer per hour, speed is VB is kilometer per hour. Or even no need to change, if it is written in meter per second, then this is, we have to convert them in second. VB is speed of bus in kilometer per hour. Let me write here in kilometer per hour and in kilometer per hour. This is given. So speed of cyclist is 20, right? So here speed of bus with respect to cyclist is speed of bus minus 20, and this is time. So distance traveled in same direction, therefore distance traveled by relative speed of bus in 18 minute is distance equal to speed into time, that is VB minus 20 into 18 by 60 hour, right? 18 by 60 hour, that is equation 1. Also the distance traveled by bus alone in t minutes is VB into t by 60, because t minutes, that is t by 60 hour, right? So both are traveling the same distance. So from first and second, both are same distance. VB minus 20 into 18 by 60 is equal to VB into T by 60. So 60 and 60 can cancel out, this can be written as third equation. Okay, so that will be third equation. So VB minus 20 into 18 is equal to VB into T. That is equation third. We can write. Similarly, in opposite direction. Opposite direction. The speed of bus with respect to cyclist. Cyclist is VBC, and that is equal to VB minus VC, and they are in opposite direction. So VB is what? We do not know VB, but we know velocity of cyclist is what? 20, minus of 20, so that would be VB plus 20, right? And time is given 6 minutes, that is 6 by 60 hours, right? So distance traveled in, so relative displacement of bus in every 6 minute is equal to VB plus 20 speed into time, 6 by 60. This is equation 4. Also, the distance traveled by bus alone with respect to ground in t minutes is VB into t by 60. So from 4 and 5 we have VB plus 20 into 6 by 60 is equal to VB into T by 60. 60 cancel, and VB plus 20 into 6 is equal to VB into T. This is 6. So from 3rd and 6 we have VB minus 20 into 18 is equal to VB plus 20 into 6. 6 3 is 18. Right. So further we can write it like 3b VB minus 60 is equal to VB plus 20. So VB will come this side and 60 will come this side, it will plus. So 2VB is equal to 80 and VB is equal to velocity of bus is 40 km per hour. Putting the value of VB anywhere in 6, from 6 you will get it. T is from 6, if I'll put here the value of here, so VB is equal to 40 into T, that is 40 plus 20, T is equal to, we can write here, from here we can write it like here we can put it that from 6 we have 40 plus 20 80, 40 plus 20 60 into 6, 60 into 6 is equal to, this is VB is 40 into T. So 0 cancel, and this 6 is 36 divided by 4 is 9. So T is equal to 9 minutes. So buses are ply after every 9 minutes, and the speed of bus was 40 km per hour. So I hope you got this right now, and this type of questions you can solve with help of relative velocity. This is all about the relative velocity, but we will discuss some numerical problems in next class as well. Some more numericals will be discussed to clear the concept, right? And some theoretical questions as well. Okay, in this lecture, this is all about today. Thank you very much. God bless you. Keep watching. And don't forget to subscribe this channel and share among your friends as well. Thank you. Thank you very much. God bless.